A much-heard explanation by flat earthers for things falling down is density and buoyancy. Later on changed in the pseudo-intellectual sounding relative density disequilibrium, or RDD. RDD is explained, if ever, as the downward or upward force being dependent on the ratio between the density of the object and the density of the surrounding medium. Whether this ratio is larger than one or smaller than one gives the direction of the force, and the magnitude of the ratio gives the magnitude of the force. At least, that is the explanation of, among others, Sleeping Warrior. Everyone in his right mind knows that this is nonsense, but how can we prove that it is nonsense? A downward force of an object you can measure with a scale, and when the surrounding medium is air, you can measure its density by measuring the atmospheric pressure. Air pressure relates linear to the density of the air. If we keep the density of the object the same, we can vary the density of the surrounding medium by letting the atmospheric pressure vary. And it varies naturally. So I weighed 100 grams weight on a scale with a precision of 1/1000th of a gram and did so for 9 days in a row. I calibrated the scale to 100 grams only one time before starting the measurements. I not only noted the measured weight, but also the atmospheric pressure and the temperature. I let the scale, the weights and the pressure measuring device at the same place during all of the measurements, and I covered them up between measurements. I took the very first measurement as the baseline. The results can be seen in this spreadsheet. Although the temperature already is part of the equation for pressure and therefore has no influence on the density of the air, a flat earther might say that it influences the density of the used metal weight. However, this influence is minor, with a temperature difference of no more than 1.8 degrees. The delta in volume will be no more than around 0.00007 times the volume at the base temperature. So the 100 gram weight at 17.9 degrees would still weigh at the temperature of 19.7 degrees 100 grams, but its volume would have increased. Therefore, the density will have decreased with a factor of 0.9999325. This difference in density only has a very minor effect on the outcome, as can be seen in this extended spreadsheet. To make it more clear, I made this graph. In yellow, the measured weights, and in red, the expected weights, assuming there would be a linear relation between the density and the force. The results were all over the place. Noticed that the largest difference in air pressure was 24 hectopascal, a difference of 2.4%, which would have to have a demonstrable influence on the measured weight, that is the downward force. And it hasn't. The difference in weight was only 0.001 gram, that is only 0.001%. And in the case of the highest air pressure, the weight has gone up, not down, as would be expected. Then I realized that flat earthers could claim that the weight was put directly on the scale, so there was no air beneath the weight to push it up. Although the air most definitely was present underneath the scale itself, I repeated the measurement with the weight attached to a piece of wire like this. The extra weight of the wire made the scale go in error mode, so I reduced the weight to 50 grams. Again, I used the first measurement as the baseline. It happened to be that in the 7 next days, the air pressure decreased, so the graph goes up instead of down like in the first 9 days. And again, although the measured weight stayed more or less the same, the largest difference measured was 0.005 gram, the expected weight, assuming a linear relation between density of the object and the density of the air, was all over the place. The largest difference in air pressure was 37 hectopascal, that is 3.6%. The corresponding weight difference was 0.004 gram, that is 0.007%. This time, the weight difference at least was on the right side. Lower air pressure, higher weight. But the correlation between air pressure and weight cannot be deduced from these measurements. In fact, the measured weight differences are so small that they can easily be explained by slight inaccuracies of the scale. If we put the measured weight in relation to the air pressure in a graph, then we see that the lines, both with the 100 grams weight and the 50 grams weight, are flat. So there is no relation between downward force and density disequilibrium between the weight itself and the surrounding medium, the air. So relative density disequilibrium is nonsense. But we already knew that, didn't we?